Good morning, class. Today we're going to be talking about the bubonic plague, also known as the Black Death. In October of 1347, 12 ships dropped anchor at the Sicilian port. The civilians were shocked to discover that almost all aboard were either dead or near death. Many of the passengers' skin blackened, as well as being covered in dripping blood and pus. The Black Death quickly spread throughout Europe and would soon be known as one of the greatest tragedies in all of history.
From Italy to Ireland, Europe lost nearly half its population. 20 million died.
The plague was rumored to have started in China, and European citizens were wary of the possible illness spreading. Nobody was aware of what caused the bubonic plague, but it seemed to spread throughout trade routes near and far east. Once struck by the Black Death, it was unstoppable. These symptoms included lymph nodes that appeared in the groin as well as underarm areas. The affected areas eventually developed into black dark blue lumps, either the size of an egg or either to the size of an apple to the less fortunate. The illness could eventually develop into a fever, pain, chills, sweating, an upset stomach, and diarrhea.
All of these symptoms eventually led to death. The death was easily spread by physical contact with one another. Doctors claim that the spread of the disease was the spirits of the dead passing by. Civilians believe that the Black Death was a punishment sent by God for their disobedience.
Where did those who lived weeping and lamenting through the bitter events that the last judgment had come?
It was a world without hope, seemingly abandoned by God.
Although the mass spread, few islands off the coast of Europe survived, plague-free. The disease was so contagious that those perfectly healthy could be dead a few days later due to something as little as a sneeze or a cough.
Successfully isolating the affected was impossible because those infected were asymptomatic for the first few days. The plague impacted the practical ways of living and building techniques. These new ways of living allowed people to separate themselves from rodents carrying the disease. The disease interfered with the social orders while Europe's population was increasing, thus created more pressure to colonize Asia, Africa, and the Americas. With very little understanding of the plague, it was easily spread. Many have thought to believe that the plague was spread through fleas or lice that carried bacteria, thus spread from urban rats, which eventually transferred to a host. The host was then exposed to a deadly bacteria. The plague not only caught humans, but as well caught livestock and many farm animals. The Black Death had transformed regular towns into ghost towns, which were eventually overtaken by the forest.
Job opportunities opened up for many of the poor people. The bubonic plague was also allowed opportunity to expand medically in viral epidemic diseases for vaccines as well as improvement in sciences. This also led to the development in antibiotics, which became effective against bacterial diseases and the bubonic plague.
Thank you for watching our review video. Now we'll be showing our amazing music video called Mama, I Don't Feel So Good, followed by our bloopers.
Once upon a time in the 14th century, people lived together in harmony. All the way back when Europe was full of luck, then ended fast when disaster struck.
Civilians were sick, people dying quick. Nobody knew what to do, so once again they blamed the Jews.
They're from the Middle East, part cities got disease.
The horror that these people saw, I bet it dropped a lot of dogs.
Mama, I don't feel so good now. Doctor says I smell like dead cow. Somebody please help me fast.
this disease came from fleas on rats? Disease came from fleas on rats, causing all of these attacks. The plague was contagious and quick, so a sneeze or cough could make you sick. 1 week in, you may be alive, but chances are you're gonna die. So much disease was everywhere, there was no cure, and that was why. Mama, I don't feel so good now. My nervous system's crying out loud. What's this black stuff under my arm? How long is this gonna go on?
Disabilities are dying very quick, and even more people are getting sick, and still nobody knows what to do. Nobody knows just what to do. 1/3 of Europeans, they lost their lives. The feudal system collapsed from the population decline. With few workers, supply was low, demand was very high. So the rich paid the poor for the goods they needed to buy. And now the poor got paid, like getting happy, creating a middle class and social hierarchy. As time went on, the number of deaths decreased, and the plague lived on in history. Yeah, the civilians are getting better very quick, and people are surviving the gruesome sick, and suddenly people know just what to do. The Renaissance is coming soon to you.